Do you have a part of your process that requires some sort of audio file to be transcribed or maybe translated? Did you know that you could do this with automation and AI? That is exactly what I'm going to be covering in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. In this particular video, we are going to be integrating ChatGPT, well, technically Whisper, one of the features or components of OpenAI. We're integrating that with automation thanks to Make, and we're going to do it all with an Airtable database. But before we get going with that, I first want to invite you to follow along with me. Wherever you found this video, you will find a link to Make. If you don't already have a Make account, using this link will give you a 30-day pro trial on Make, which is no small thing. So be sure to grab it and sign up and follow along step by step as we go through this training. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and set up our scenario. So here's the basic idea. I've got these files, some audio file, an MP4 ideally, and I want to send it over to automation and receive a translation or maybe a transcription. I'm going to be covering both of them at some length in this video. So the idea is that we name whatever this file is, and then we are going to have a status here when we are ready to send it out for our automation. And so we're going to move the status and that will trigger our automation. Now, of course, we also need for there to be an attachment file right here. So this is the actual MP4. And then lastly, we're going to have our transcription from Make get dropped in here inside of our Airtable base. Now, of course, you don't have to use Airtable per se. If you don't want to, you could be using Google Sheets, Smart Suite, or any other database type of tool that has the same capabilities that I'm going to demonstrate here. All right, let's go ahead and set up our first example. So the idea is that we're going to take this file, whatever it is, from Airtable and use it inside of Make. So here I am in Make and I have a brand new scenario that I haven't even created yet. Now I want to start with my favorite Make trigger. This is my favorite way to communicate between Make and Airtable. I'm simply doing a search here for webhook. I'm going to pick the webhooks icon here. This is part of the Make service. And I'm going to select the custom mail hook here. Now, when I do this, I can choose an existing hook or I can add a new hook. So I'm going to simply say add and I can name this whatever I'd like. I'll call this test for Whisper. Whisper is actually the name of the feature within this ChatGPT that we're going to be using in just a moment. So I'm just calling this test for Whisper. Let's go ahead and save this. Now, this address is actually an address that we can send an email to. So I'm copying this to my clipboard and I'm saying okay from this step. Now I'm going to flip back into Airtable. Now what I want is for something to happen in Airtable under certain conditions. Then I want to send the information to Make and I want it to be received at the catch mail hook that I've just created. In order to do this, I go into my automations, and first I'm going to set the conditions for the record in Airtable. So what are the conditions that I want to include that will initiate this automation? Well, for me, I have to pick my table. I only have the one table, and I set up my conditions. Number one condition is the transcript status must be send to make. So if I haven't set the status to send to make, obviously I don't want to send anything. Now, the next status or condition that I want is that the attachment exists. This means that I have already uploaded an MP4 file. If I don't have a file, then there's nothing for me to send to make, and so this automation doesn't make any sense. So I want those two things to both be true, and when they are, that will then initiate the automation. Now, as a next step, once this has met these conditions, now I want to send email. And I can use the simple Airtable email here. Inside of this email, I'm going to paste the webhook that I created and copied in Make. So if you recall, just inside of Make, it produced this long URL, or in this case, mail hook for me. I'm pasting this in as the to, so that way we're sending the email to that address. Now what I want to do is include my Airtable record ID in the subject. In order to do this, inside of the subject, come on down and find Airtable record ID. Now, the nice thing about this is if I need to know what that record ID is throughout my Make automation, all I have to do is look at the subject of my email and I'll have that information. Now, I also, for this one, need to include a message in my email, but I don't actually care what that message is. So for me, I'm just going to write test. So you could put whatever you wanted in here. We're never actually going to use the message in the email, so it can be whatever, but I just cannot leave it blank or this automation won't be valid. Now, as a final step, what I need to include here is the attachment file that I have inside of this entire scenario. So the attachment that I've uploaded that I want to send over to Make to transcribe or to translate, well, I'm going to pick that attachment here and I'm including it as an attachment to the email. Hopefully this all makes sense, but the key components are record ID in the subject, anything you want inside of the message of the email, and lastly, I need that very attachment from the record that triggered the automation. I need to share that with Make. Let's go ahead and name our automation now. Name it whatever you'd like. Be sure to turn it on. And once we're all set, we can send a sample piece of data over to Make. Now, I don't have a new record yet, so I can add a new record and I'll call it test 4. And what I want to do is create an attachment here, drop a little MP4 file in, and then when I'm ready, I'm going to say, hey, I'm ready to send this to Make by selecting that option here. That will then push that file into that Mailhook that we just set up. All right, so let's create a little file here. I'm going to open up my sound recorder on my computer, and we can just bring that in over here, and I can start recording something. And because we're going to need to translate, I'm going to record something in French, and hopefully, it will be able to be understood by Make when we put it through this particular automation, and we can bring the transcript back into Airtable. So let's get started. Here we go. I hit record. Je m'appelle Gareth Pronovost et je suis le fondateur de GAP Consulting. GAP, c'est G-A-P Consulting. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. So I go ahead and say I'm done there. And now what I can do is right click here and I'm going to show it in folder. We'll open up the actual folder where this file is. It's recording 10 and I'm gonna drop it into my attachments here. So I'll drop, open this up, click, drag my new MP4 in and I'll upload that file. All right, so now I am pretty much good here. So I'm gonna go into Make and I'm going to right-click my webhook and run this module so that it starts looking for that file. All right, now I'm going to say send to Make, and if I flip over into Make, what's gonna happen? Airtable now takes that information, sends that email to Make, and what does Make receive? Well, let's take a look. It has the body of test. Remember I said we need to include something there, but it doesn't matter what it is. The subject is the record ID. And also, if we look at our attachments, we have one attachment because I only had one file. And here it is, recording number 10. Here's the file size. And I actually have the file itself as well. So let's do some work with it. First, I want to run this file through ChatGPT through the Whisper feature. So let's look for a new application here, ChatGPT, and we will find it here. There we go. Oh, OpenAI. Sorry, ChatGPT is a portion of OpenAI. And so I'm looking for Whisper. And you can see here that I can create a translation and create a transcription. So the translation will take some audio and translate it into English. That is currently the only option. And the transcription will create a transcription of audio to text. Now, I have not tested the transcription for multiple languages, but I have checked out the translation component, and that's what we're going to be looking at here. Now, in theory, these two things are going to work very similarly, whether you need a transcription or you need a translation from one language to English. So for us, we'll run with the translation. And here we go. I've got my OpenAI connection. Of course, this requires that you're also set up inside of OpenAI and that you've integrated that with Make. And it first asks me for these two things, the file name and the file data. So let's say map, because we're mapping to previous steps in our automation. And my file name, if you recall, it's all gonna be received here in my attachments. So I open up my attachment and here is file name. Really simple. They didn't make it very difficult for us to know which one I need to find. So file name goes to file name. Same thing for file data. I open up here, this is also required. I look inside of my attachments again, and here it is inside of data. So map your data to file data. The model right now, the only model available is Whisper 1, and here's where I can include an optional text guide in my prompt to guide the model's style or continue a previous auto segment. The prompt note should be in English. So all I want to say is, please translate this to English, which it would do anyway, and do not include the original language in your output. I don't think that I actually need to add this piece here, but as an extra precaution, as an extra step, I include it and I'll say okay. So that's it for us here. Now, because I can't copy that attachment into this, I'm going to have to move on to the next and final step, which will be going back into Airtable with this information. So now that I've presumably translated it in this step, now I'm going to upload that text into Airtable from the transcription slash translation, and let's go ahead and first upsert a record. So this assumes that we know the actual record that we are working with. First, find your correct account here, my Airtable connection, and now I'm going to find my base, which I've named Whisper. There it is, and give this just a moment to think. Now I have to map to my table, and again, for us, I only have the one table. And the record ID, thankfully, we know what this record ID is. If you recall, we brought it in the subject of our mail hook. So the subject contains only the record ID, so I can use whatever that record ID is to now update that same record that triggered the automation. Now, all I really want to update here is the transcription itself, but I also want to update the transcription status. If you recall, we have a few different status back here in Airtable. And when this is completed correctly, I want to update it to say transcript received. So inside of my automation, I can just paste that text right here. And so when this automation runs, it will automatically update the status. But here is where I want to bring in the transcription. So inside of the transcription, I can find this inside of the OpenAI module here, and all I have to do is grab the text that is produced as an output of this transcription. All right, so that is all I need to do in this step here. If you want to, as a final step, you could add an error here as well. You could say, if this particular module is not able to do what we asked it to do, if for some reason it breaks or we can't seem to perform our automation, well, then we could set some sort of other condition, right? We could say, well, in this case, I want you to go to Airtable. And in this case, I want you to update a record. You could also use upsert a record. They're pretty much the same in this particular scenario, because in every case, we will know the record ID and we will know that the record exists. So here I will go again into my Whisper database. And I will say on table one, now what I want you to do, if for whatever reason you can't do what you needed to do and we error out, well, then I want you to update the record that you received in the mail hook. And I want you to update that record with what? Well, just come in here and let's say errored out on that status. So you'll notice here we have a final status of error, which is a way of alerting us, hey, something didn't quite work as planned. So inside of this status field, I just need to say error. So this is a great way for you to add an error into your make automation so that just in case something doesn't quite go as planned, you are alerted back inside of your database that something is messed up, something is awry. And you can tell that this is an error path because if you look here, you see the hollowed out dots, which tell you exactly that. This particular path will only be followed in the case where something goes wrong and you can't complete this particular module. All right. Let's go ahead, save our automation. Of course, we want to name it. So I will call this translation from Whisper. And we will have to again save it. I always forget to save. And then turn on our automation. And let's back up here and we'll take a look at it once we've iterated a few times. So because I have already got all the information right here, I'm just going to right click on this particular record and I will duplicate this record. This will create a new record that meets the conditions to send this information over to our system. And you can see that we received that webhook, and it took a while for ChatGPT or Whisper here to do the thinking for that translation. Let's pop back in and see what happened. Pretty darn good. So my name is Gareth Pronovost, and I am the founder of Gap Consulting. That is what I said in this attachment file. I said Gap is J-A-P-E, but I have a terrible accent when it comes to speaking French, so they picked up J instead of G in French, which is my fault, not Whisper's. So this worked appropriately, and you can see that the transcript status was properly updated to show that the transcript was received. So imagine all of the different possibilities that you have with this kind of technology. If you have any kind of MP4 files, whether they are in a foreign language or otherwise, you can drop them directly into an Airtable database or something similar, and thanks to the use of Make, send that file over, have it transcribed, have it translated, and brought right back into your system so that you can keep working as quickly as possible and you never feel interrupted. This is a really powerful tool. I hope you get a lot of value from it. Drop any questions you have below wherever you found this video. And in the meantime, keep on building.